हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू वी किड्स चैनल।
मॉरल स्टोरीज, बेस्ट फ्रेंड्स फॉर एवर। वंस अपॉन अ टाइम देयर लिव्ड अ किंग। ही वाज वेरी फाउंड ऑफ हिज रॉयल एलिफेंट। द किंग प्रोवाइडेड हिज एलिफेंट विद द बेस्ट फूड एंड अ लार्ज टेंट टू लिव इन। द एलिफेंट वाज हैप्पी एंड कंटेंट। अ डॉग लिव्ड इन द सेम किंगडम। All day it would roam in the streets in search of food, but rarely got anything to eat. It was weak and its bones used to show through its skin. One day the dog was looking for food around the elephant's tent. When it peeked in the tent, it was amazed to find all the food that the king had arranged for the elephant. Tempted, it got inside the tent when the mahout was not looking and began eating the food. From that day on, the dog began to live with the elephant and feed on the food that the elephant did not eat. The elephant too did not seem to mind. In fact, he had found a friend in the dog. With their time, their friendship grew. Together they began to live happily in the tent. The dog's health improved and he began to look very cute. One day, a man came to visit the mahout. He liked the dog very much and asked the mahout if he could have the dog. Since the dog was of no use to him or the king, the mahout agreed and the man took the dog with him. The elephant was very sad to have his friend taken away from him. He began to miss the dog very much. He stopped eating and fell sick. The best animal doctors were called to look at the elephant, but they failed to make him better. Then one day, the mahout remembered the dog. He realized he had done a mistake. He went to the king and told him everything about the dog. At once, a messenger was asked to announce in the city for anyone who had the dog. Anyone who has the dog which lived in the royal elephant's tent must return the dog to the king immediately. He shall be paid by the king for it, the messenger announced while beating his drum. The man who had taken the dog did not lose any time in returning the dog. The elephant gained its health again when he got his friend back, and they spent the rest of their lives in each other's company. The moral of this story is, to lose a friend is the greatest of all losses. The Drummer's Son. Once upon a time, in a small village, there lived a drummer with his wife and his son. The drummer was very skilled. He would often take his son with him to all the weddings, festivals, and fairs where he played his drums. Slowly his son also learned to play the drums and began to play with his father. One day, a traveler from a nearby city liked their drumming and advised them to go to the annual fair that was taking place in his city. The drummer and his son set off for the city the next day. It was noon when they reached the fair. It was a large fair and people from near and far visited it. The drummer and his son took their stand in the heart of the fair and began to play. Soon some people gathered around them. Then more people came to listen to their drumming. They began to clap with their drumming. Some of them even danced to the music. Money began to pour on the sheet spread in front of them. When the day ended, the drummer and his son were very happy with the amount of money they had earned from the day. They counted the coins and set off for home. The drummer could not wait to share the news with his wife. On the way, they had to cross a forest. It was getting dark. The drummer knew that the forest was home of some deadly robbers. He warned his son to be quiet while they crossed the forest, but his son was very confident after the day's success. "We will go through the forest while playing our drums," his son said. This will scare the robbers away. He continued to play his drums loudly while they walked through the forest. His father kept on saying him to stop, but the son did not listen to him. The robbers in the forest heard the sound of the drums. They wondered how many people were crossing the forest. They hid behind trees and watched the drummer and his son. When they found out that they could easily attack the two men, they did not wait any more. The poor drummer and his son were robbed of all the money. They had to go back home empty-handed. The moral of this story is always act as per the situation. The Clever Crow. It was a hot summer afternoon. Last night's storm had blown the crow's nest away, and he now needed a new nest to rest at night. After the day was done, the crow perched on the television antenna and rested. He was feeling very thirsty. He began to look around him for a drink of water, but he could not find any leaking tap or puddle. The sun was shining brightly, and it made him thirstier. Suddenly he noticed a pitcher in the distance. The crow flew towards it in the hope of finding some water in it. And it was the crow's lucky day. There was water in the pitcher. But no matter how much the crow stretched inside the pitcher, he could not reach the water. He kept trying for some time. Finally, he grew up and began to think. Bits of rubble lay in a heap nearly. The crow had an idea. He swooped down on the heap and picked up a piece of rubble in his beak. Then he flew back to the pitcher and dropped the piece in it. He continued this for a long time, and slowly the water began to rise. When the water had reached the brim, the crow dipped his beak in it and drank to his fill. He was very satisfied and happy with himself. The moral of the story is, if there is a will, there is a way. Hope you all love this story, and in coming videos we will come up with more and more stories you can enjoy. Thanks for watching. Please do like, share and subscribe our channel for more videos, and do not forget to tap on the bell icon to receive the updated videos of our channel. Thank you. Bye. And let's meet with another exciting story. Bye.